And gentlemen, welcome. Welcome to the Mount Hermon Charity Challenge, where we will be having teams play for charity, playing for the children. To go. More importantly, saving the children. My name is Morality Claws, and I'm joined today by my friendly co-caster, Moist, as we cast this game, Enzo versus Team Bad English. How are you doing, mate?
I'm doing very good, thank you very much, and I'm loving this matchup today. Team Bad English have been playing fairly well recently. We've seen them do pretty well versus strong opponents before, but Enzo, I haven't heard of them as of yet.
Yeah, they're more a localized Russian team. Not very popular in the Western scene, I believe. But, you know, we'll see what their qualities are now.
Very typical bands coming out from both teams. SF, very, very strong at the moment. Also with the Wisp. I don't think you really need to ban Wisp. Like, I just think the tiny ban is all you really need to ban out at the moment. I don't think Wisp is too potent without that tiny. The Doom as well, that's just a normal standard ban right now because Doom is just so strong, it excludes any hero.
And of course
fight,
the Dazzle.
And then Dazzle as well.
And we're going to see some very typical picks coming out here as well. Slada, which has been sort of flavor of the tournament, really, with the major ending. Slada being picked up here and there, being picked up a lot, actually. Mostly
by
Team Secret.
By Team Secret.
Yeah, there you go. Queen of Pain, of course. I mean, what else do you want from a mid, is the question.
Ganking potential from Queen of Pain is unreal. And Wind Ranger, yeah. Wind Ranger is also a really good matchup against the Queen of Pain. Because you've got the power shots just to nuke out the creep wave and go collect the rune. Also, really good base damage as well as the Queen of Pain. So, Wind Ranger usually can go quite even on CS. But when Queen of Pain hits level 6, Wind Ranger will, you know, really does struggle with that lane just because of the kill potential from the Queen of Pain.
Radiant ban. You got a point there. But you have to remember, Wind Ranger is one heck of a solo DPS hero.
Yeah, I do agree here. Dire's but ban. What's really... One crucial mistake here by the Dire, right, is they haven't picked up their supports. And now, what the Radiant team are going to do, they're just going to keep banning out supports here. Like, the most conventional supports here are Winter Wyvern and Dazzle, and both of them have been banned out here. To
go. Yeah, you
like,
saw it
I'm thinking Bane.
5 seconds.
Bane is an interesting choice. I haven't really seen Bane a lot in the competitive scene lately. Reserve time.
Yeah, we'll see what happens, but I think Bane is really, really strong right now.
You forgot
really
Lich, though. I mean, Lich has been one of those flavor of the month as well, with a few buffs coming in. I mean, the ice... Jesus.
Sacrifice.
Sacrifice, of course, being buffed back to its original levels of funniness.
10 seconds to go.
Yeah.
And, of course, his Q, which I'm currently forgetting the name of.
Frost Blast.
Thank you. Frost Blast, which has been buffed, I believe, to do quite a bit of damage.
Yeah.
So, more of a flavor month. Along with, so with Disruptor.
Dire's pick.
So, to talk about the Darkseer here.
Okay, the Darkseer, well, well, you have really good initiation here with the Tusk as well. You just surge up the Tusk, he snowballs in, puts down the Ice Shards, and you're pretty much good to go. And it's also really strong against the Slardar and the Wind Ranger because they're very mobile with the sprints and the wind runs, so blocking off their path for the Sigil is really strong. And the Seer is really good against melee carry core, or just the melee core in general. Really disrupts them from getting CS, and it really leaves them low. So just a rotation from the Tusk or the Queen of Pain could just be like the killing blow on the carry.
Good point there.
And his pointy head has been seen a lot recently. And
oh, yeah.
I think he's tier 1 pick at the moment. Tier 1 pick, tier 1 ban. Like, his team fight potential is unreal.
He was always,
vacuum,
though.
Sonic Wave right now, you'd be seeing a lot of damage going on.
I mean, he was always team fight potential. That's the reason you pick Darkseer, mostly.
And I think Gyro right now is a block pick. I don't think they wanted to pick this up.
No, not really. I can see it as well. I mean, combine a Gyrocopter with the Darkseer and you have a very, very potent combo, especially because Team Bad English are still missing a carry.
Well, the reason I think they've block picked here is because Gyrocopter naturally builds into an MKB and is really strong against Blink Dagger heroes like Slardor and Windranger, as well as has really good synergy with the Darkseer, so they've picked up the Gyrocopter now to prevent Team Bad English from picking it up, in my opinion.
And you know what? It isn't such a bad block pick after all. I mean, the problem, of course, is that they now have a sort of a free core lineup, which is not ideal, but... You know.
They've just returned the block pick, actually, because there's a really good setup here for the Bane and the Slardar, and as well as the Gyrocopter Rocket Barrage. So I think both of these teams, you know, doing a bitchy drafting stage right now.
Counter-picking each other, basically.
Yeah.
10 seconds to go.
Pretty much. And what would I like to see coming out from the Dire? Well,
5 seconds.
They have really good control between the Shackle Shot and the Slithering Crush. Ruptor's been banned out by the Radiant. I think Ruptor would have been really strong versus the Darkseer and the Queen of Pain, because you can just glimpse them straight back.
I can understand. I can see where you're coming from, yeah.
They have a lot of mobile heroes. Treant wouldn't be a bad pick here. Treant's really fallen off recently, but I think a Treant or a Lina could be pretty good.
Well, you forgot about Undyne. That's Radiant. Something that punishes... Early ganks really well.
Could see a support Slardar, and this could be a core and dying, but we've seen teams, you know, preferring to dual lane with the Slardar.
You know, that's actually interesting. How would you lane this? Would you like put the Gyrocopter in the safe lane with the Undying? Or leave the Undying going in the off lane, have the Slardar as a support, or maybe going with the Undying?
What I'd like to see?
Yeah.
Well, looking at the things right now, Bane was just Nightmare, and then you got Snowball. So there's no way that Slardar could solo this offlane. Unless he can crush just after the Snowball, he should be able to survive, actually. But a Gyrocopter will be solo, well, will be safe lane, and the Windranger will be mid. We just don't know if they're going to pull up a tri lane. But they can't really kill the Darkseer with the Undying of a Gyrocopter.
They don't have enough in terms of stun and lockdown.
No, they don't have any lockdown at the moment. They have damage, but just no lockdown at all.
Unless you level missile, which no respectful gyro will do.
No. This could be a missile game where you can get at least one or two levels in it, but me personally, I just prefer to get one valued point in it and then just go for stats all the way up. We'll have to see what happens. But Enzo need one support, and Team Bad English are probably looking for their safe lane farmer right now.
Something that synergizes with the Darks and the Bane.
Reserve
we'll have a look now. I'll have a look.
The Anti-Mage could have been okay, but...
Yeah,
I'm not so sure about it.
AM sort of gets, you know, sort of gets shat on by the Windranger anyway, so...
Yeah, the solo DPS will just screw them
over. I think they've got no way to deal with this Wraith King. If they pick up a Wraith King right now...
There's no mana burn.
There's no mana burn. Maybe the Anti-Mage...
You just kind of fell off there, hello?
10 seconds to go.
I think I've lost my co-caster.
In the pool, and there's Wraith King in the pool, so I'm thinking those two heroes, probably. Probably. Alchemist!
Alchemist's still in the pool, that's actually a good point. Thing is, does he work here?
Alchemist! Not so good against the Queen of Pain.
Uh-oh, we seem to be having some connection issues on my end again. I will reconnect as soon as possible. What the heck is going on? Keep talking.
Vector is in the pool.
Ah.
Dire's pick.
Alright, so
picking up... take it late game.
So they pick up a PL.
Oh no, they need a support here, sorry.
Yeah, I mean, they've got enough cores already. I don't think they need another one.
They really lack lockdown, so I think a Lion could be quite strong.
Versus the PL, though.
I know he'll melt here, but with the Queen of Pain Blink, the Tusk Snowball, the Darkseer Surge, I think Lion could be the way forward.
Thing is, it feels very much like they can... Like, Enzo... Like, the fact that they completely neglected on knockdown at the moment just... Feels like the PL is going to tear them all apart. If they let it go to the late game. Unless Gyrocopter can get some amazing rockets off. And with that, I mean cooldown, of course. The Witch Doctor could do well here, though. The bounces, if he gets some lucky bounces going. Problem is, it's only one support.
I know, yeah.
And before we get into this game, I'd like to remind everyone that it is a charity tournament. So please do donate. We've got some good incentives going.
It's $1, your name shows up.
$10 to go.
$1, your name shows up. $5, we will read your message on stream. $10, you get to choose the song for the breaks.
How amazing is that? And you're helping children.
Yeah. Helping the children. It's all towards a good cause, ladies and gentlemen. But for now, let us get into this game as we have the complimentary pause going on. We thought it's ticketed. Alright. They're apologising for not having their real names. And to be honest, I can understand. And oh dear, there we go. Anyway. So, your thoughts on the drafts. Who do you think is going to win this if we would have, like, equal footing?
Well, Enzo's early aggression. Like, Wind Ranger needs one or two items to be effective, and Gyrocopter has really good magic damage early. And they actually have really good PL illusion clear as well. So, if Enzo can use their early game momentum to propel them forward into the late game, I'm backing them. But for the simple reason that Bad English have really good team fight potential, as well as the PL, which is really good at split pushing and make. And with the Queen of Pain, the Darkseer, and the Tusk, they'd probably look to make loads of space around the map for the PL to push. But we'll have to see what happens. And late game, I think Enzo have it. But their mid game is... I wouldn't put the Enzo's mid game better than the Bad English's, in my opinion. Let's see.
And for the late game, like you said, it's going to be a difficult, really. It really depends on who gets the most farm first.
Just for the simple reason that a Gyrocopter would be building Butterfly MKB. Even if you needed to, a Divine Rapier, I don't think these PL illusions will stand. And that's what PL needs. Especially into the flat cannon and the cooldown.
It needs health on these illusions to make them tanky.
Yeah, this is going to be a struggle for PL early. It's all about how they lane it, because Enzo have pretty much left their draft wide open right now. They're not sure if they would run an aggro try, defensive try lane. They could run dual lanes with the Slardar Witch Doctor. We'll have to see. And we have a lovely pause.
They have 15 minutes. That's the way the rules go. And again, we don't know how internet is, ladies and gentlemen. We don't know how internet is.
Yours.
But here we go. They're loaded in, and we should be getting right back into this game. Into the first few minutes, at least. The game hasn't even started yet, officially. So, who would you like to present, is the question.
I might go for the Radiant. I think they're easier to say.
All right, then.
Okay, we'll have Pwn playing the sexy Darkseer. Going on the solo safe lane. We have Tusk being played by Giga. Queen of Pain being played by Inura Tensei.
Yep.
Is that right?
Yep.
I butchered that. We have PL playing, being played by Overwhelmed by You and Zenigata on the Bane.
Alright, and for the dire side, playing for team, and so we have Muriel playing the Slardar on the solo offlane. At least it's what it looks like. We have Six, please some Russian guy tell me how to pronounce that, playing Undying. We have LTW playing the Wind Ranger. We have Swanky playing the Witch Doctor. And last but not least, we have ?? Playing the Gyrocopter. Now, they had their names originally. That's what it looked like, but now they all lost them for some reason.
Why is this Undying lost some health?
I'm not even sure. Oh, yes, no, they had a small engagement on the bottom offlane.
Cool.
UTP's coming in, and it looks like we're actually going to have a first standoff here at the bot rune. I'm going to go with I think Enzo's chances are really stacked here since they have an Undying. And Overwhelm for you will get stunned up and he will fall first. In fact, Senigata will probably be caught in a very tricky situation as well. Good shards, but will it stop the Undying? And yes, it will. Decides not to pursue. Meanwhile, Muriel slowly with 300 movement speed chasing down Giga.
Yeah.
And once again, Undying on Senigata. Senigata walking right back on the Undying. Thought he had backup and eats his way through the trees, hoping he can get away.
It's a fast zombie horse.
Oh no.
There you go. Undying's going to punch Giga right in the face right now.
And that's already one kill starting up for the Undying. Not even 1 minute into this game. Two kills for Enzo.
Yeah, and they got a kill on the carry as well. It's quite unfortunate for Overwhelmed by you. Yeah, and here we go. They're going to rotate the Bane in here. And they're going to TP him back. Senigata, what? Okay, he's going up there to trade hits, but this is not the right
no.
move, mate.
Undying will once right again decay him. Health goes down. They're going to chase him down. Will Overwhelmed by you be able to defend Senigata? No, here comes the crush.
He just walked up there and fed.
That was an interesting move by him. And there's the shards. Trying to get the Undying, but he'll walk it off. He has decay stacks on.
I'm going to wait for the decay stacks to tick out before he pops the tango.
Get that health economy going.
Yeah, like I said, it's just going to be an even mid. They're just going to... Oh, God. Queen of Pain taking a really heavy hit then. She brought the salve out because the power shot would be maxed by the Wind Ranger. It's just the most logical
thing
to do.
Oh, going in ballsy here. Wants to get some good damage in on ITW. ILTW.
He's got two levels in the Shadow Strike. This could be quite dangerous here.
I think it will. She has got two tangos, so she should be able to survive. But it's still going to be... Take a heavy toll on her health.
Look at me.
Oh
right
my
now,
god. Nothing was able to be done with that. Except that Bane is waiting. He only has a brain sap though, so there's not much he can do.
And the blink was forced out by the mid lane. He, ILTW just got a really good chuckle there, and then the power shot came through. Nearly killed him. But Swanky, invis. And looking at the Wind Ranger, she's only got a tango, so she has no salve to go through.
It looks like she's going right in again. Salve was used by the Queen of Pain. Point back power shot. It's going to take a lot of damage for ILTW, and she might even die to this, but Swanky's here to back it up. They might be able to turn this around. And they do. Will Shadow Strike kill? It will!
He was 1 HP away. 1 HP, because Shadow Strike ticks you down for 30. Just 40, but plus the magic resistance, you know, it's 1/4, so it's 30. So 1 HP. Died off 30 health.
Looking back on the bot lane, lots of pings going up there. In fact, looks more like the top off lane. You want to look at Pwn really deep.
Yeah, this Darkseer is actually getting quite a lot right now.
Yeah, he's level 4 already. That's pretty significant.
This is a happy Darkseer.
Yeah.
His beard goes longer, and Zenigata right now just in the face by the crush.
Muriel's taking a lot of damage though from the PL. Doesn't have Slithering Crush yet, will get saved by the Soul Rip here. But the K's out, Zenigata will not fall however. It's barely survives that one. In fact, they're going to turn it right around on the... Where's the Snowball? Snowball in onto the Undying.
And we just see the Slardar, you know, swim away casually. But this early aggression on the bot lane, giving up the Undying kill there, especially when Undying's got 1 kill, 2 assists, there's quite a bit of gold going that way.
Oh dear, Muriel, unable to get the bounty room, blocked off perfectly there. Oh, will he? Nope. She wants revenge.
He got the Orb of Venom here.
Oh, he's going to be able to slow here, and Giga doesn't look like he's going to get much backup, but... Muriel doesn't risk it.
That's probably wise here.
User joined your channel. And someone has joined us.
Yeah, sorry, hey, switch the scenes.
Thank you for telling me. I just noticed.
User left your channel. Okay. A nice appearance from Sander.
Normal Chief Caster. Make banners smaller is what they said, and is what I will comply. You will see the change coming.
I'm just picking a sander real quick.
Anyway. What do we have going on here? Mid lane. Looks like ILTW is going to get hit by the Bane. Where's the Queen of Pain? Queen of Pain is low. Here comes the backup from Swanky. In fact, they might even get Senigata down here. There's the focus fire. Senigata will not die, however. Where will the power shot come in? He's going to deny himself. He did. And now one-on-one, Swanky versus Shinra Tensei. Shinra Tensei will probably get the... No! Good! Good self there, but it will not save him. Or will it? Is the Voodoo Restoration enough? And yes, it is. And meanwhile, on the bot lane, Tusk dies to Muriel. Meanwhile, right back in on Dion dying.
Yeah, we have Bad English on the Radiant side and Enzo on the Dire side, just to clear up anything up. Yeah, to clear
people. Anything up. Left is Radiant, right is Dire. That should be pretty obvious. Let's have a talk about the Gyrocopter since, for some reason, the last hit denies wasn't up. 33-7 currently for him, 6 minutes in. Like, Darkseid is 31-3 on the solo offlane. It's something to admire, really.
Yeah, this Pwn is above par right now. As, you know, you're looking about 25 CS about the 5-minute mark as a carry in the safe lane. So, 31-3, they've done absolutely nothing, and here we go. This is a very, very dead... Oh no, and then we have the Windranger TP in, and Swanky with the cast coming out. Uh-oh. And Gyrocopter takes a call. But, Swanky on a killing spree? Wow.
The Witch Doctor is doing fine this match. In fact, Queen of Pain also killing Muriel on the bot lane. Will Undying fall as well? No, he will not. Dear God, I just noticed something. It happens when you are not, when you are in stressy situations, you forget to do some things, and I forgot to change the box quickly. Excuse that, chat. Please spam me if you do wish so. Anyway.
Always spam him. Yes. You know, him and his 2K, just spam that shit.
Oh dear. But let's have a look. Let's talk about both carries. So Gyrocopter just died, but he still has 34-9 compared to the PL with 27-10. PL is catching up, but he's still been just overwhelmed by the excessive pressure on the bot lane, and he's now having a go at him again.
Yeah, we're probably going to see a lot of pressure being put on this PL, just making space for the Gyrocopter, because Enzo know that if this goes late game enough, like, they'll win this easy. Like, Witch Doctor with Aghanim's, Windranger, you know, pulling up a couple Daedaluses. Like, this is an easy game for Enzo if it goes late.
Radiant's mid tower's coming apart.
Like, we haven't seen any objectives being taken as of yet. It's 8 minutes in, we haven't seen them all committing for a push. And we have a Nightmare on the bot lane.
That's going to be a very dead Muriel. In fact, there's the Snowball, there's the Decay, trying to save him. Muriel! Oh, Bane! Getting to the lucky. Getting a lucky last hit there. Over one by you. Or, no, Bane will be the target of this Windranger.
Power shot to finish it off. The turn animation was so slow.
And now the Undying will die to Shards. Or more likely the Phantom Lancer. Shards just helping out here.
Yeah, it's a 2-for-1. That's really good for Bad English.
Dire's mid tower's having technical difficulties.
Yeah, but in the meantime, you have the Queen of Pain just sat on mid right now. He's trying to get some chip damage into the tower, but not a lot's happening. And that's it. Sonic Wave's up now. Is he going to blink forward aggressively?
Muriel.
In 1 second, he'll go for this.
Oh, he does hit it, but he will probably take a fall in return. Will Swanky be able to get the last hit here? He will. Now, Swanky, he's probably going to die versus Giga here.
Oh, he popped the mango.
Not the best of decisions. Now Giga's getting chased down, but will be able to snowball away to creeps.
Yeah, he was hoping to have enough pop the voodoo. Oh, the power shot from downtown.
Windranger.
Oh.
Was that luck or skill is the question.
They have no ward on the other, on the enemy high ground, and there wasn't a creep standing up on the cliff, so it could be seen as luck.
must do something about that bomb.
Yeah, it's a lot of pressure going on for this gyrocopter. He has to keep ferrying out sounds all the time. And what's also really strong with the PL, you can just doppelganger out from the amplified damage. Last much longer. So it's quite easily purged. And we'll probably see the PL now looking to get an early boost of travel. Oh, here we go on the top lane. They're going to be ganking the gyrocopter. And they're going to start off with the shadows right clicking forward and the right click coming in from the green.
Now, Windrager coming in. Nightmare up on her though, so she will be unable to assist. They've got three man rotation coming in top along with the Slada moving in from spawn.
Oh, here we go.
Here
Swank
goes.
With the cask again.
Send a guard to Wolffall.
Okay. Aim didn't go for the
That was four man rotation.
Now on the Windranger.
That was a four-man rotation. They tried to save the Gyro. Well, they didn't even try to save the Gyro. Gyro was dead. And all they got was the Bane in return. That's not worth it. That's not worth it at all.
Exactly. They really need to not leave this Gyro alone. But Enzo, with their, you know, their early game momentum, like, it's 9 and 12 right now. They should be a little bit more ahead than they should than they are right now. Like, having a look at the goal graphs.
Oh dear, Windranger getting sucked right back in with the vacuum and will get brain zapped to death. Another kill on the Windranger. And here we go, Grid of Pain going aggressively on the Undying, who has to pop Tombstone here. Will this save him though? Will he have any backup coming in? He has backup coming in from behind. Ice Shot hit and the Shadow Strike finishing it off. But here comes the Gyrocopter with the Rocket Strike. Getting a kill on Zenigata, who was on in the snowball here, and he will take a fall for that.
Oh, Queen of Pain, he's coming.
Oh, Muriel getting a good kill there, and but Swanky, here comes Swanky,
here
the ult.
He's giving him the... Oh, you're gonna go, Swanky,
will he get the kill? Solo kill on the Queen of Pain, unable to do anything. Free for free. And
this
that's
is an Agon Inceptor game for the Witch Doctor, man.
Oh, yeah, it is.
But what have they got to stop it, right? They got Nightmare, they got Fiend's Grip, that's two of them. And they're Tusk, Snowball, and the Vacuum, so there's not really a lot right now. And I don't think Witch Doctor's the main target. Ah, poor Swanky. That's Clarity denied by the groups. And this Gyrocopter is taking way too much damage right now on the top lane.
He's taking too much damage from creeps, and that's the bad part. Look, he has to fuse or call down to farm an easy camp. Meanwhile, Queen of Pain gets the double kill actually on to Swanky, so get some of that gold back. He's building this up into a orchid.
Dire's top tower's getting beat down.
Yeah, that AWP is going to be important. This smoke gank, if they catch up the Gyro here, this Gyro is going to stay behind for most of the rest of the game. It's 68-16.
Yeah.
What was that? Hey, me. Had some weird echo there.
Me. I didn't have weird echo. You did.
Interesting. Yes, I'm having echo from you in game. Anyway, smoke gank coming in from Enzo. Who are they looking for? Who are they looking for is the question. They're not looking for anyone. They're in fact going for Rosh here. Thought they were probably going to go on the PL. But decide they can take Rosh instead. They're melting Rosh down pretty quickly. Gyrocopter getting beat down by Queen of Pain again. But if they can grab Rosh for this, I think everything would have been worth it. And there, that's the Aegis of the Immortals for the Queen for the Windranger.
Yeah. With the Slardar and the Windranger, it's just so easy to pick up Roshan. And Overwhelmed by You just runs away from the crush.
I swear that setting was on. Anyway. Oh, here comes aggressive Blink in from Tenzai. But sees the two others and immediately gets out of there.
Oh my god, these casks coming out from Swanky, man, they're so lucky.
Skill.
Yo. That's Mirana. That's not luck, that's Ski. Well, we're looking at the Dire Ward, right now. We've got some protection over the mid lane, and we've got one deep inside, well, I wouldn't say deep inside, just on the outside of the Radiant Jungle. And there's also one scouting out the top room that has just been freshly planted. I don't think these wards right now are looking to take objectives, just more for the protection for the Windranger.
Oh, there's Shinra Tensei, getting nightmared up here. Oh, what a vacuum wall, though. They managed to get two here and pop the Aegis.
Oh. Punching down in the face.
And now ITLW. She pops the Invis though and is able to get out free, scot free with the gyrocopter taking the brunt of the damage here. But both of them get out alive, so in the end, they lose Aegis. No, they lose the gyrocopter. Aggressive blinking from Shinra Tensei once again. Killing off the gyro.
Yeah, it's really good nightmare by the Bane there, saving the Queen of Pain's life.
And Muriel blinking in aggressively to Shinra Tensei. Set up from the Shackle there. Nightmare again trying to save. And there's the Gasks again. Here comes the Death Ward. They kill off Senigate. But you know what the funny thing is?
What?
Shinra Tensei got out. But not able to get away from Muriel.
Not from Muriel. Just picked up that fresh Bling Dagger, sir. Overwhelmed by you, he's topping up the CS right now, and he's got the Ashra first. He's probably going to build into a Vladimir's after the Boots of Travel. I think that would be the smart play. Let's see what's happening right now. We've got some drawings coming out of the map now. Muriel's probably going to pick up some smoke. They're going to look to smoke at the bottom tier 2 right now. Hopefully. No, they're just going to walk away from it. No. There, you've got no smoke anyway.
But looking at that, I mean, just the gyrocopter is extraordinarily poor. 4.2k. Well, you know what's actually the funny thing is that on net worth, the Queen of Pain, and the Phantom Lancer, and Pwn are all leading. Even though it's been looking like Enso's game, if you want to put it in quotation marks here. Just from a pure fight perspective. They're trying to take some objectives now, but here comes the entirety of Team Bad English. All smoked up. Muriel manages to get that smash off, but here comes Shinra Tensei. That's a vacuum wall. This is dangerous. This is deadly. Muriel will fall, but what is Swanky doing?
Okay, here we go.
Swanky getting a double kill.
I told you, Swanky is on fire on this Witch Doctor right now.
And even with that net worth advantage, with the net worth advantage, they are unable to get a 2-0.
Okay, the Queen of Pain is just next to Swanky right now.
Oh dear.
Nah, they can't kill the Witch Doctor. Okay, here we go. He goes in with the Orchid, the Sonic Waves up, and that Shackle out of nowhere, and the Power Shot goes through.
There's Shinra Tensei!
Okay, he gets off the ultimate.
Swanky is...
Sigil's coming through, just about picks off Swanky.
Swanky unfortunately takes the fall down. That's a killing spree. Tusk, I think, can be okay with that.
Okay, here we go. We've got the Snowball in. And the Sigil in this as well.
There's a Nightmare up onto the Undying.
Yeah. And here we go. Like I said, everyone by you. He's going to be picking up this Boost of Travel. He's going to push in the top lane.
Oh, missed the Slithering Crush. But now, here's the Nightmare again. Not able to get him off before the Tombstone comes down. And Senigata will try and Fiend's Grip up Muriel. But will be unable to achieve anything here. There's the Crush up onto Senigata. And now, Soul Rip. Decay finishing off the Bane.
What I haven't been seeing recently in Pro Dota is the Undying skill build. He's got 2 points in the Decay, and he's maxed out the Soul Rip, as well as 2 points in the Tombstone.
Maxed out Soul Rip is...
And he skipped his ultimate as well. Like, the damage amplified 20% at level 6, which is just... extraordinary, especially with the Witch Doctor lockdown. With
I'm wondering about that as well.
The cooldown too.
There is no reason not to get that. Like, you want insane heal, great, but come on, you're
exactly.
Old. You're old. There's a lot more damage. Lets you do a lot more damage.
Yeah, and we don't really see Tombstone, you know, being skipped. Like, two levels in it makes it so underwhelming, in my opinion. Like, we haven't seen the Tombstone really take effect. Especially against the squishy supports like Bane.
And it's going to drop off now soon anyway. Like, we're about to approach mid-game. We're about to approach a threshold where Tombstone will become less and less effective as time goes on.
I think Tombstone is a really big factor in fights if you can't afford to hit it. Okay. Really good reactions coming out from Giga there. as I was saying, like, the tombstone is a really big factor if you ignore it. So, say if the cores of... Well, PL is a core and Queen of Pain is a core. As a core, you need to pay a lot of attention to them, not the tombstone, primarily. So, maybe it's a good decision here, but... I think Soul Rip and maybe getting the Flesh Column was the better build to get this game.
Definitely feels like him.
Yeah.
Looks like Shinra Tensai is in a bit of a interesting situation up there. They do see him, but unable to do anything. Well, let's have a look at ice in comparison. Like, Gyro has... Okay, Windranger has finally finished up Aragonims. Gyro has... Power Treads, Drums, and an Aquila.
Dire's bottom tower's getting the business.
Bought the drums, yeah, okay, he's got the drums up now. We have Undying looking to get an Urn of Shadows, I believe, and we see the Glimmer Cape now on the Witch Doctor. I swear that Swanky needs to get an Aghanim Scepter. He needs to get his team back in the game.
That's going to be very delayed, though, with these support items coming out. The Medallion of Courage, the Arcane Boots, and the Glimmer Cape. Those are all expensive items.
They really need to drop this Undying now to position 5. They need to let Swanky get that Aghanim Scepter.
To be honest though,
honestly,
like,
how are they going to deal with it?
Looking at the Undying's items, it feels like he's been position 5 already. I mean, Swanky has a lot more just items in comparison to him.
Yeah, Swanky's not doing too bad at all. He's doubled the net worth of the Undying.
Speaking of net worth, let's have a look at the graphs quickly. Yeah, about 5,000 going up to 7,500 for Team Bad English. With 5,000 XP going towards Team Bad English. So, they're leading on net worth and experience.
Exactly, but, yeah, and they're, you know...
Oh, there's a good vacuum wall once again, but only getting two. And on the back line, Muriel jumps in with the Undying on the background. They get the gyrocopter down, not before he gets the cooldown off. Swanky is unable to do much. Here's the death ward. What a beautiful death ward.
Like I said, man, Swanky is on.
Oh, what was that shackle, though?
Nail in the coffin there.
What was that shackle, though? The
I don't know, but the minus 15 armor on the Queen of Pain, and that's like just two desolators. And then you just have, you know, the Wind Ranger coming in strong as well. And Wind Ranger is just going to focus fire down this tower on the bot lane, uncontested.
Meanwhile, though, they're getting him push mid. It really is just a slow push on the side of Team Bad English. I mean, they have been losing fights left, right, and center, but they are leading in net worth, and they realize, okay, you know what? We don't need to fight them directly, like, anymore. Look at the PL. He's split pushing now. He's got the Boots of Travel off. Muriel actually gets a Slivering Crush off on him. This could be bad, but no. Still scared of the PL.
I think he could have killed him. Like, he could have purged off the sprint.
I decided to purge himself off instead.
Yeah, he was TPing bottom anyway, so I think that was a waste of a charge.
And he's leaving his illusions there as well. Well, I mean, they don't have too much of a duration, but, you know, take him with him. No, anyway. Next item on PL, probably going to be the Vladimir's Offering. In fact, no, he's actually going to get the Manta Style first.
The Manta Style. We're not seeing many silences coming out, and by many I mean none. Maybe for the confusion factor could be really good.
I'm wondering, like, Queen of Pain, she has been a factor, but she hasn't been really, like, the Sonic Wave comes out, and yet, Enzo find a way to stay alive throughout these fights all the time.
I do think the Orchid was the better pickup here, but they really have to fight around cooldown.
Ooh, here we go.
Cooldown's bad English. Like, Enfeeble with a 100 second cooldown, they got 2 minutes 15 seconds on the Sonic Wave. And, wow, it's only really Tusk and PL who would fight at an instant.
Oh.
And here we go, we got Muriel going in.
On Giga, Giga will snowball.
Are they looking to snowball all the way up? How unfortunate.
Oh, Giga's probably going to take a fall here. They even commit the cooldown. And the tombstone.
Committing the kitchen.
ILTW with a solo DPS onto the Bane. But here's the vacuum wall. Once again, on point, but it's not enough.
Coming through. yeah,
would have been amazing tonight. And use the space to get Rosh, get the objective, mate. And that's a 3k gold swing for Enzo. That's pretty good. 3k experience swing as well. So yeah, easy Rosh. Once again, Wind Ranger will pick up the Aegis. And she really is the damage dealer. I think the Aegis on her is the right choice here. The Shackle not being an what-the-fuck Shackle right now, but the solo DPS.
Oh, he pops the BKB and just about gets out here.
I feel like he could have done it without the BKB, though.
Wow.
You never know. You never know.
Our Bongos was on cooldown, the Shackle's on cooldown, and the Crush was on cooldown as well, so yeah, you're probably right. But it's always better to be safe than to be sorry, right?
Still, 10-second BKB does feel a bit painful.
It does a little bit, yeah. I think the Queen of Pain needs... I don't know what she needs. I think an Aghanim Scepter is still not too bad. Just for the simple fact that they need that ultimate just up all the time so they can take the fights. Without that ult, they can't take it.
She's only got 400, like 500 gold though. I mean, she had to buy the BKB, and that's a huge drain on her gold story. Speaking of which, Bane doesn't have any items of significance. Being 211 and 7 with 8 last hits.
He's got his Zone of Shadows, he's happy.
He's happy
got his wards, got his Magic Stick. What else does he want? Support life, man.
I don't know, maybe a Glimmer Cape would help get the Fiend's Grips off better.
Yeah, and we got the GPM backing up on the out and.
Oh dear, here we go. Overwhelmed by Yu was gonna die here, but will they get a counter kill on Muriel? Solrep saving him, but the vacuum wall. ILTW is going to get. Is she gonna get out? She will get Fiend's Grip up. The control is real. Here comes the snowball. They are going to kill her twice. And Shenrai Tensei is looking for more blood.
Get that fight recap up, man. Tell me the twink.
Only 1,200. The XP is only 1,000. Shinrai Tensei coming in here, but the Death Ward doing too much damage. Cooldown being used here defensively. Giga tries to roll in, but will be unable to do much. Solrip up onto the Undying. Here comes the Rocket. There's the mech. They're going right back in.
Giga just taking it all in the face right now.
And we have a donation.
And he's popped the BKB. He's looking to get aggressive. And no, they're just going to disengage here, which I think is the wise decision. That's a 2-for-2 at the end of the day.
But right, recap.
I think that maybe Enzo gets the better of the trade here. Well, even though they did trade off the Aegis, bad English.
I mean, they lost 1,000 net worth but regained 1,000 in this fight. And they regained the XP they lost, so in all, it was pretty even.
Pretty even overall, but... You have to take into consideration that this PL is not on the map, he's not farming, he's not getting that next item, which I think he'll get Skadi next, because he really needs to slow down the Taro and slide up.
It probably will be Skadi, because Orb of Venom, Ultimate Orb, do look like typical Skadi items.
He's getting Skadi now.
Muriel and ILTW, though, they're aggressively looking for targets here.
There's only two people here, and they've got three people.
Oh dear, here's the Shackle! Yeah, the Vacuum trying to save Overwhelmed by Yu. In fact, Overwhelmed by Yu will get out and ILTW will take a fall. Muriel as well. The TP reaction saving the life of Overwhelmed by Yu. Misplay by Team Enzo there.
Misplay? That was a stupid play. There was only two of them in there. The Undying and the Gyrocopter is sat on mid right now. Maybe trying to pick up the Radiant Tier 1, but I think that was a useless exchange. It shouldn't have been exchanged. They shouldn't have engaged there, especially with no vision on the right side of the map. Hey. Like, we're seeing a load of objectives right now that Enzo haven't claimed. Like, there's a tier 1 on top and also the tier 1 on mid. But Queen of Pain and the Darkseer can just push out the lanes so easily. And all of these lanes are being pushed in. There's no pressure whatsoever coming from the dire side.
I mean, really, what kind of pressure can they commit right now? They need to kill the enemy team before they can commit anything.
Exactly, yeah. And the dire side, it's an early game lineup, and they need to capitalize on it. And it's getting, you know, it's getting to the 30, 35 minute mark. That's when PL really gets into his prime, as well as the Queen of Pain, and they're just going to look to take fights around the map. And look at the leading GPM right now. We've got PL and Queen of Pain just massively ahead right now. And even in net worth, is 1,500 gold ahead of the Gyro. This Queen of Pain, quite frankly, and the PL don't give a shit. I'm going to have a Shiva's Guard coming out with Queen of Pain, which is going to reduce the attack speed of the cores, as well as give her a bit of intelligence and a bit of armor to work with as well. Really
but
counteracts
we were talking about this.
Stardar.
I mean, we were talking about this one. Didn't we say she probably needed the eggs a bit more?
Yeah.
I'm thinking, like, I don't think Skadi's the right play here, if you ask me. I feel like the eggs are still the right decision. He has a crit. Yes, she does.
Yeah, Fizzo talking to me.
That's a lot of damage on the Wind Ranger. Combined with the minus armor from the Slada, if they don't get her down, which they did do pretty well these last two engagements that we did saw.
But they did commit the Enfeeble for her, and that's not the main target they really want to Enfeeble. Like, Swanky right now, well, when Swanky gets his Aghanims up, he will be the person, like he's only 250 gold away.
Oh damn, Euro blinks in aggressively, but will immediately get snowballed, immediately falls. Reactions by Team Bad English here. And immediately Enzo just back off.
Enzo just waiting for this interception on the Witch Doctor. And it's going to be up in about at least 34, 33 minutes. And then they're just going to look to take the fight. Swanky is their saviour.
You said in 34 minutes.
Okay, he might just sell the magic stick right now. He just needs it.
Because Overwhelmed by You is about to push through, but here comes the... This is good job by Shinrai Tensei, though.
Oh,
singling out the IoT Del. Well, nothing of value was gained or lost, except there goes the tower. Lots of ultimates were committed. But now Overwhelmed for You. What a shackle! Oh, but once again, IoT W being controlled
Swanky
up here.
Oh, he's dropped the base here.
He's got the axe.
God,
that's,
that's
a lot of damage.
If it was only one more level.
But here comes the snowball, and they're waiting for us. Giga will die. Midrax are falling though. There
nah,
you go.
It should be fine. Banky really needs to get his level 16. I know I have to keep saying really needs this, really needs that, but the level 16 will be some massive impact right now for the Dire side, which they really need. And the physical damage as well, the armor reduction coming from the Slardar works so well with the Witch Doctor and even the Gyro and the Wind Ranger.
You know what's funny? Slardar just picked up a Shadow Amulet, which means he's either going Glimmercate, which does make sense with his utility build, or he's going to get a Silver Edge or something, which doesn't make too much sense in my mind.
I think Glimmercate.
Yeah.
Mid tower's coming apart. But he would have bought it by now, so maybe a Shadow Blade.
Silver Edge, but what's that to Silver Edge? I mean, you could probably get the... Oh, getting a good kill on the Senigata. Right here. ILTW's jumping in to finish it off. He's a bit more farm, he does.
Yeah.
So I'm wondering, you know, like, what you get a Silver Edge for what exactly? To kill the PL? You need to find the real PL first.
Apart from that, they have no passives, really. They have no passives at all. Apart from the PL juxtapose.
Which, I mean, is significant, but does it warrant getting a Silver Edge just for that?
No. So, maybe the Shadow Blade just for the sneaky initiation, to be fair. I don't think it is for the bonus damage. It's just so he can just creep up on somebody and just pop them.
And we were talking about in the drafting phase how a Gyro really needs an MKB. Well, what do you know? He just picked it up.
Yeah, that, you know, the plus 88 damage as well as the mini bash coming out should be really strong for the Gyrocopter. And it also does a lot of damage. Gyrocopter does a lot of damage in a short space of time, so the MKB will just help prolong his damage output during the fight. You know, he can pew pew a couple people individually.
Pew pew, like that terminology. Anyway,
indeed.
Yeah, he Slardar picked up a Shadow Blade, so sneaky initiations incoming, I see.
Yeah, he'll need to do that right now because the Dire warding is really strong right now, and I think he's noticed that. And the warding game's just not so good because Swanky was, you know, going for the Aghanim Scepter, and Undying is been tanking up with some braces, so they haven't really dedicated too much of their economy to the warding game, so kind of like could be decent, I see. And the gem on the Undying as well, just to secure some map vision now.
You know, Shinra Tensei did not actually get a Shivas. She got an AC.
Oh.
I think it's because the Darkseid has the Shivas. I'm not sure though.
Yeah, I think that is the better play, and we do see a lot of Queen of Pains in competitive picking up the Assault Karas.
It is a good damage item. It's also great for the armor, of course, the anti-armor. Doesn't exactly counteract Slardar, but it does help.
Oh, it does help, and it's really good against the Witch Doctor Ultimate as well, and he's got his level 16. He's only just got it now. So, let's watch it go, man. Watch it go. And Roshan's about to come up in the next, I don't know, 10, 20 seconds? He's up. Sorry, the big man's up.
Good. The pig's coming out now. On him. Cheese is up on him as well, so... Important to get. Muriel will blink in.
Now you'll watch Team Bad English now. They will just focus Swanky right now.
They'll have to focus Swanky. If they want a chance of surviving, they have to focus Swanky. If they focus Swanky... Yeah, DD on Windranger. I'm sorry. But that is one heck of a damaging Windranger. Of course with DD, but she's got 3.2k gold saved up.
Oh my, this PL.
Yeah, he just got a Satanic.
Yeah, they've really left PL alone way too much this game.
You know, let's have a look at net worth once again. And it's 10,000 up to TBE. Which is great. I mean, you can work with that.
Yeah.
And it's 5,000 XP only for TBE though. It's like not the huge lead you expect them to like have with such a net worth advantage.
Like, this gyrocopter has got nothing on this PL right now. Like, PL could just do anything right now to wreck this gyrocopter. One-on-one, easy. Even with the cheese, I'm backing PL here. Just for the simple fact that he has to sustain from the Satanic.
What happens once PL gets a butterfly is also the question. It's like, okay, fine, the MKB. The MKB, but I mean... What would you get now, though, is the question.
On the PL?
It's like you have a Satanic, you have Scuddy, you have a lot of health. You don't really need damage since you're doing 200 per hit. I mean, you can always get more, but...
Well... By the looks of things... I think he should get an MKB himself, for the simple reason that... The Swanky has a channeled ability, and Gyrocopter and Windranger Gyrocopter naturally builds into a butterfly, and you have the natural evasion on the Windranger as well. So I think that maybe MKB would be the smart choice on the PL now.
Very cautious plays going in here, though. Both teams not daring to cross the river. Waiting for a misinitiation, or even just a normal initiation. All quiet on the Western Front, as people say.
Indeed. The calm before the storm now, and the Dire is pushing in. They realise that...
Oh, there you go, blink in, but no shackle there, as Giga's able to blink right back out. And now, ILTW gets silenced up. Gets four stuffed out, then this is the initiation. They're waiting for one, a vacuum wall. Already killing two. Gyro is controlled with the BKB up, so already a waste of BKB. Cooldown is activated. Where is the ult, though? Team Enzo is falling apart. Oh my god. Senra Tenze using his ult for the first time during this fight, and now they will kill off both Swanky and the Windranger for the first time.
This is it. This is Megas.
That's it. ILTW will die for the second time here. You know what went wrong there? The Windranger going full in aggressive on that. And they were... Yeah. Like, Enzo was...
Take the fight anyway.
Yeah, Enzo was forced to reinitiate. And that was what probably cost them this fight.
They had to go all in.
Just look at the gold swing. It's 4,000. It's almost 5,000. It's a 10,000 XP swing. 10,000!
They had to go all in there. That was the good good play from Enzo. Like, they knew that if this PL and the Queen of Pain get any bigger than they are now, they have no chance to get back in. So they had to just five man commit to a team fight. And if you saw at the start of that fight, they just focused Swanky. They didn't want him getting his ult off. His ult was channeling for about 2 seconds maximum. Because they knew that he is their damage right now. The Windranger has loads of single target damage, but it's just not coming through right now. And the Gyrocopter has no sustainability as soon as that BKB wore off. And Bane did perfect there, just to grip him at the right time, when his flat cannon charges were up, and his BKB was activated.
Yeah, really, the Bane is what basically cost Enzo that fight there. The Gyrocopter just falling to there. Oh, there we go. Cooldown is here, but the PL...
Yeah, the cheese, but...
The PL is dying! It's the MKB, but the flat cannon. PL was controlled throughout the entire fight. General Tensei will be the next casualty if he doesn't watch out. There's the Enfeeble up on the wind range, but it's only doing minus 12 damage, and with the Pocus Fire, that's still enough.
He has some time to doppelganger out there, and he maybe had some time to pop the Satanic, I'm not sure, but he did pop the Satanic there. I think they could have, you know, taken more racks, but they're two racks in.
Whoa,
they miles
just
and miles ahead of the radio.
With
I think
the,
it's over.
Hang on, with these three kills though, they made back a gold swing of 6,000, almost 7,000, and 8,000 XP. I mean, of course, you're two racks down, which is horrible, but you basically almost made back what you lost in a really, really misplayed
team fight. Gara's doing the best play right now. He has to go rapier.
Oh, here we go.
Yeah, he has to. There's no other choice.
Well, I mean, that's obvious. I mean, they're losing at the moment. Rapier is basically the logical pickup right now. There's no other item
you
can get.
You only ever get Rapier if you're miles behind.
I mean, that's really...
miles ahead.
I think that's the only opinion. I mean, why would you risk losing?
Exactly. Like, when you get a Divine Rapier, your testicle size increases by a certain percentage. And you get really cocky and you start doing plays he shouldn't be doing, and he's got the cheese as well, so it's not like this is an unbacked up divine. This is a decent time to pick it up. Ever casted a game with a divine before?
Yes, I have.
Oh, here you go, there's another one.
It's not as uncommon as you might believe.
No, it was by divine.
Yeah, you do divine. I'm wondering what the win and loss rates on divines are. Like, overall. I bet they're high, usually, because pubs do mess up win rates, I believe. In pro competitive, though, I would like to see what's the stat on that. Anyway.
Friendly banter.
So, yes, this will be one of those moments there. Another donation coming in. Anyway. One of those moments, then. But yeah. We will see. This next fight will be the one to decide all of them. And here's the initiation. There's the cooldown. We'll overwhelm by you die, but there's the vacuum wall. Oh my god, the Sonic Way. Where is the Undying? Where is the Gyrocopter? The Gyrocopter trying to do as much damage with the Satanic. The cheese. The Walrus Punch controlling it up. He doesn't have enough health for this.
He's fine.
He's not getting out of this. Overwhelm for you will take him down. ILTW will be full, and there's the GG.
Again. It's just on the floor. GG.
What a play!
Yeah, and they got defined on the PL. It's all over.
I'm sorry. That was a good last fight. That was a really good last fight. Enjoyable to watch. I knew it was over the second they lost the gyro. And the gyro did everything in his power to stay alive, but he just couldn't, you know, stay alive. Versus the PL.
Yeah.
Anyway, that would be it for game one.
A strong force.
That is true, especially in the late game. Anyway, that's it for game one of this best of three. Stay tuned for game two, being casted by myself and Et Moist. Or Zach Owen, depending on which one you prefer. I prefer Moist, if you ask my preferences.
You prefer Moist.
Anyway, once again, stay tuned. Thank you.